quadjacks.com. Well, this is an honor and a privilege to be sitting here with Mr. Matt Savage. Sir, thanks a lot for joining me. I've done so many interviews at this Detox Poker Series. I've interviewed everyone short of the floor sweeper. Okay. And now you are my dead last interview. I said we were going to save the best for last. Okay. You're like the final boss in a video game. You know, now I must defeat you. And then I'm done. Then I win. Sir, congratulations. It's been an excellent series, I think. I had a blast. Thank you so much for having me. I'd like to ask you this. What were your expectations, perhaps, going into this series? And now that it's all over, well, kind of. We still have the player appreciation tournament in the back there. Now that it's coming to a close, what are your thoughts?
Well, I mean, for this series in particular, I really wanted to do something for the Vegas locals. It's been a long time since I've been in Las Vegas running a series, since the World Series of Poker in 2004. So I really thought that it'd be nice to get connected again with the people that I live with, since I do live here in Las Vegas. And, you know, I wanted to show something to them as far as the structures. Instead of having deep stacks, which seems to be rampant through Las Vegas now, to show them deep structures instead of deep stacks. And I think that it really worked. A lot of the players saw something here that they haven't seen recently, and they seemed to really appreciate it. That being said, we had an up and down series. We had a big starting weekend, made the guarantee, a couple slow days in the middle, which I kind of expected, and then a big final tournament with a big guarantee making it. So I was happy with that. My focus for the whole tournament basically was to be player friendly, do things that they don't see on a normal series, and basically to detox from the crazy month of poker that happened last month with World Series Poker.
And speaking of player friendly, it's not just the tournament is friendly to the players. The players have been very friendly among themselves.
Yes.
Like, this kind of thing seems to, you know, generate a lot of sympathy among the players because maybe of the deep structures. It makes for more play in the longer run, and everyone has a good time. And everyone, maybe because it's a locals based thing, everyone just seems to be more friendlier.
Yeah, I think a lot of these guys know each other. They play together all the time, and I think that. You know, makes it to where, you know, it's like a cheers, you know, everybody comes in, everybody knows everybody's name, so it makes for a better series, I think.
Very well done. Speaking of friends, now I understand that you have a close relationship with the 2+2 forums. You're a moderator, aren't you?
I'm a moderator for the tournament circuit results. Basically, anybody can post up their results as long as they clear to do that. And I've had some good times doing that because, you know, obviously there's different events around the world. So the fact that they're posting their events results up gives me a chance to look, stay connected, see who's doing well in the industry. And, you know, if a player that, you know, won a tournament in Austria comes in next week and I say, hey, congratulations, you know, on that tournament, they're kind of like shocked by that. But it's because I'm able to keep up with what's going on in the industry. 2+2, in my opinion, is one of the greatest ways to market your event, to talk to the players, to get to know them better, to listen to them. I think I'm a very good listener and I want to keep that going. You know, if they have to complain about something, you know, 9 times out of 10, you know, they have some good input. Let's say 5 times out of 10, they have some good input that they want to give. Yeah, about half the time it's a good input. And, you know, I don't mind listening to that, making changes, making tweaks to make the events better for the players.
Very well done. It's funny you should bring up Austria because I think I've recently become a hit in Austria. Yeah, and it's actually, I think it's on 2+2, if you research my Austrian video. Well, never mind. No, but that's very good. So, you listen to a lot of what the players have to say on 2+2, generally, you know, in your encounters with them, you're very receptive. Is that what makes you the best at what you do?
Well, I mean, I think... thank you for saying that, first of all. I'm going to always keep improving, always trying to be better. I think you should always try and be the best at what you do, whether it's playing poker or running poker tournaments. And, you know, like I said, listening to the players, knowing the rules, being consistent, and being firm with those guys. And, you know, a lot of times these conflicts come up, and as long as you know what you're doing, you know the rules, you know how the process goes, it's going to make for a better experience for these guys. And I think, you know, structures is part of that also. So, you know, the fact that we do those little things here and in all the series that I run, I think that makes for a better experience for the players.
Right. I really do mean that because I must be frank with you. I've only been involved in this whole poker thing for like 10 10 minutes, perhaps longer than that. But no, but I'm really into it. At the same time, I don't. There are still some things or some people with whom I'm not wholly familiar. And for a while before this started, I kept hearing Matt Savage, Matt Savage, Matt Savage. In the beginning, I was like, "What's? Who is this Matt Savage person?" Everyone was like, "Matt Savage, Savage." You know, like even when it had nothing to do with poker. You know, like, weather sucks today, but you got to give it to Matt Savage for being a total badass. You know, it's like wow. And then we got involved in this detox business, and I've seen you and your excellent team of collaborators at work, and it's just, this is not even a question, it's just me expressing my my admiration for what you do. Please give my regards to everyone who's worked with you.
Yeah, I do have to say, I mean, we have great dealers here. They had great dealers already at the Hard Rock. It's, you know, I bring in 20 dealers with me. I bring in, you know, my right-hand man, Dave, and Sam. Sam, those guys are great. They just, you know, work so hard. I mean, we're here every day, pretty much beginning to end, and we want to make sure that everybody has a good experience, and I think that, you know, the staff goes a long way making that happen.
And it's great that Detox was such a success, because I hear that the Poker Lounge is being relocated.
Relocated, I think actually it's going to be a good thing. It's going to be a little smaller, it's going to be a little brighter, it's going to be out on the floor a little bit more, so people that walk by can see it. I think it's going to be good for a game or two more for them, and I think that's a pretty good move.
Detox was an excellent swan song.
Yes. I think we should have given out hammers or something.
That would have been pretty interesting. The players themselves.
Yes.
You know, or that should have been one of the prizes on the money leaderboard, I think.
Yeah.
You know, like second or third or fourth, you get to rip the whole damn thing down the way you want it. It's not too late, sir. Now, can you tell me more about the World Poker Tour? I hear you're involved in that.
Yeah, I've accepted a job as the executive tour director for the World Poker Tour. It's pretty exciting because they've made a lot of changes early on since I've been on. And I think we want to make it a better, again, player experience. We want to do things that are both player-friendly. And not only that, I think that some of the communication between the players and the World Poker Tour had been lost in the last few years, and some of the communication between the partners, the casino partners, and the World Poker Tour had been lost. And it's really my job to, you know, make that gap smaller. And I think it's worked for the most part already. We've done some exciting things. We just had the raw deal at the bike. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to go to that one because it was here. But, you know, at the same time, I think that in the future, I'll be at more and more events. I'm going to Borgata for their World Poker Tour event. And I just really hope to make it a better experience for everybody involved.
Very well done. So on that note, because we've had such a great time hanging out with you and your peeps, and just because your tournaments and your events are so excellent, where might we be if we wanted to stalk you a little bit, or, you know, be your roadies or groupies? Where might we find you in the coming weeks or months? Well, what's
right
next
now? It's about 1 a.m.
And please don't lie to me just because you want to lose me.
At 6 a.m.
I'll find you.
At 6 a.m. I have a flight that's going to San Jose. Bay 101 is my home. It's not where I live now, but I consider it my home. It's where I was born and raised. Bay 101 Casino starts a series tomorrow morning. The Bay 101 Open starts at 9:30 in the morning. So I'll be running a tournament tomorrow morning for 8 days there. The main event's 2,000 and 1,000, two different events. After that, I fly back to Las Vegas, get in the car, drive to the Commerce, and run a 19-day event there, the Commerce Hold'em Series, which I'm really excited about. Some big guarantees for small buy-ins, and I think it's really great for the locals and people who can fly in for great distances for that. And then I drive home that day and then fly out that night to Borgata for the World Poker Tour. So I'll be pretty busy for the next month.
Pretty busy indeed.
Yeah.
What do you ever rest, sir? Do you ever?
I had some time to rest during the World Series. As a matter of fact, I got home from a long road trip with family right before the series started. But I played some events during the World Series. Kept you know, my feet wet with the poker business. But at the same time, you know, it took some time off as well.
That's right, because you play as well, don't you?
I play as well. I mean, not as much as I'd like to, but I get to play occasionally. And I really enjoy playing.
It must be difficult, because I take it you like to play.
Yes.
You enjoy playing a great deal. You know, is it like sometimes difficult to be like, oh my God, you see all this poker, I can't wait to get on a table?
Sometimes, but I really do love my job. I do think that I have the greatest job in the world. I mean, I really like being able to meet all these people, and you know, I actually would rather work than
play.
Play.
Really?
Yes.
Wow. That does not describe me at all. But that's great, Mr. Savage. I'm good for you, and best wishes to you. Thanks a lot for speaking to me. Thanks a lot for this excellent series again. Thanks a lot for having me. Great
job. I would love to have you guys come out again to another series we're doing. You guys do a great job, and I've been watching and enjoying some of the videos you've been doing, and hopefully I'll get to see them all when I get home. I'm going to check them out.
Oh my God, really?
Yeah.
I'm going to hold you to that. Yeah. Both the watching them. We may have to do a Clockwork Orange Ludovico treatment sort of thing for some of them. Okay. But yeah, we really hope to catch up with you. You're the perfect gentleman. You're an excellent man, an excellent tournament director, and I could go. I really could go on and on.
Thanks, Mark.
Praising you. I'm really quite smitten.
Oh.
Thanks a lot, Mr. Thanks. Savage. Good luck to you, Mr. Savage. I've defeated you, the final boss. You know.
Exactly.
Right there. All right then.
Thanks
Thank you so very much. From the Hard Rock Poker Lounge, this is Budjacks.com with Matt Savage. Good night, everyone. Hope you had fun at Detox Poker.